Hello there, everyone. Welcome. Jeff Moore here with Bedford Camera. And, you know, we are here at PhotoCon here in Oklahoma City. And my good friend, James Pratt, second time into our Photo Expo.
Yeah, it's welcome been great. Again. Yeah, I really enjoyed it.
All right. So, yeah, you know, glad to have you in with these expos. I mean, and you've always had some wonderful presentations. And this one, you talked a little bit about how to get published.
Right. Yeah. I've been published in a lot of different magazines all over the world. And, you know, there's kind of some tricks you got to do to learn how to, you know, shoot your photos, but also how to deal with editors and how to submit the right kind of stuff. And, you know, you want to try to, you know, there's a few tips and tricks you can do to make your, you know, be more likely to get published.
Yeah. And what are some of those that, like, top tips and tricks you could share?
Well, number one is read the publication. Mm-hmm. You know, they do not like you to submit things that you don't know anything about the publication. You need to read it, understand it, mm-hmm. What type of stories they like, what kind of photos they like. Number two is if you're not a writer yourself, work with a writer. Because mm-hmm. people, they don't buy photos. Magazines don't buy photos, they buy stories. Mm-hmm. And you got to be able to tell a story. And so a lot of times you're going to be working with a writer. Mm-hmm. I get assignments mostly, but when you're first starting, you'll be wanting to work with a writer or somebody and put together a story, pitch it to the magazine as a one coherent piece. Mm-hmm. And so stories, you know, learning how to tell a story with your camera. For example, one of the things I talked about is when you're out shooting photos, they don't, you know, you can take what I call hero shots,
right?
Which are these stunning photos they use for double page openings or covers. They're, you know, just these really awesome photos. But they don't need 20 of those. They need like two of those. They need, you know, we did a story where we were riding motorcycles from Canada to Mexico, dirt bikes, all along the Continental Divide. And I had these incredible photos of riding bikes in the snow-covered mountains, crossing streams, you know, these what I call the hero photos.
Right.
But the editors, they want to see the camping, the cooking, the people you meet along the way, the flat tires you had. So all those things help tell the story of this trip we took, this epic trip.
Yeah, telling the story from A to B.
Right.
And everything that happened in between.
Right, right. Okay. So it's not just making a few beautiful photos. You got to do more than that.
Mm-hmm. Now, as far as open communication with a writer, do you kind of go in and have an idea of what kind of shots, or do you just kind of go in and just see what kind you get while you're...
No, you just usually get what I could get. You know, sometimes we'll set up photos. Usually it's just get what you can get. It depends on the story. But I did a story for ESPN on a young girl sprint car rider that the driver had been burnt real badly. Mm-hmm. Did a story about her, so that we did a lot of setup stuff on that story. So we had to set them up, position them, you know, shot her in a race car, at her shop where she worked with her dad, mm-hmm. things like that. So you'll do some setup. Others, when we're doing, you know, I was out last week photographing at a grain elevator, and I'm basically whatever, you know, I'm climbing up a big grain elevator with a camera hanging from my back, and dust is flying, the wind's blowing, I'm getting whatever in the heck I can get, you know. Yeah. So it's not, yes, yeah, it's a little bit of both.
And so basically know the publication. Know what they're aiming for.
Right.
And keep the selections minimal, right?
Yeah, you want to, you know, typical pitch I have, mm-hmm. a typical submission, I may shoot on a really big story, along like a multi-day story, I may shoot 300 photos total. I'll edit them down to 150, and I'll submit maybe 50. Mm-hmm. Let them pick from them. And you're going to have a mix of, that's a feature story. You know, if you're doing a one-pager, it'll be fewer. Mm-hmm. But if you're doing a feature story, you may have 50 photos you submit.
Okay. Now, one of the things that a lot of folks who come by the store and they're getting into stock photography, and so they know that with stock photography and all, they are extremely picky about, you know, the quality of that shot.
Yeah, I sell quite a bit of stock. My mm-hmm. stock is different than, I don't shoot for stock. Mm-hmm. I shoot my assignments, shoot the things I'm doing. I think about stock when I'm doing that, and I'll take them. So I'll take photos that I think can be used as stock. Mm-hmm. But so my photos are more of a, you know, the stock stuff is, for example, I sell a lot of motorcycle photos, mm-hmm. and the key for me is to keyword the heck out of them. I keyword them, I caption them, a lot of detail in the metadata about the photo so that people, I sell photos worldwide, and people can find me on the internet and find those photos of that particular motorcycle doing these particular things at these particular locations. Mm-hmm. And so in that case, it may or may, the quality may not be such an issue for me, because mm-hmm. I'm not selling dye stock or anything. I'm selling real specific photos, but so it's not a huge quality issue, but it's an issue of finding a shot that tells these things.
Right. And another thing that's also kind of important is that even if you get rejected, you know, you don't want it to get you down.
No,
I mean, just
rejection.
Keep going.
And I heard a good comment yesterday. And when somebody gives you a no, it's not necessarily no, it's not right now. Mm-hmm. So a lot of times your editor, if you submit a story, it may be just that they've already run the story, mm-hmm. they've already done something like it. It just may not be a good fit for that time. You know, that doesn't necessarily mean it's a no permanently. So yeah, don't give up. I bug the heck out of people. I don't bug them. I try not to bug them, my editors, right. But I try to let them know, keep in contact with them, let them know the projects I'm working on, and keep up to date with them.
All right. Now, a lot of folks can see your stuff at jamespratt.com.
James-Pratt.com.
James-Pratt.com.
Somebody already got me on James Pratt, so I'm gay. I got James-Pratt.com, or just Google my name. I come up real easy.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I got a lot of stuff there. And I have a really very busy blog. I blog a lot since I'm a writer. I write a lot. And so I get a lot of information on my website.
Okay, but a lot of helpful information. Thank you so much, James.
Thanks.
We appreciate it coming by.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
Right.
I really enjoyed it.